Eckert Bendik Guðmundsson, CEO of N1, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
So how do you think the listing will benefit N1?
I think it's important in general for the economy that the listed companies, the number of listed companies will gradually grow. I think it's beneficial for the investment world that companies are listed. Gives the opportunity to individuals and professional investors to trade shares in companies, large and small, and also to monitor their performance much better than they could otherwise. And for us specifically as N1, being in the service of the population at large, individuals and companies all around the country, I think it's very beneficial for us to be in the ownership, to have a large shareholder base. And we saw in the IPO there were several thousands shareholders that wanted to, or investors that want to become shareholders in our company, which I think is a large number in Iceland at least, and gives us an even better connection to the people that we are serving around the country. And if you also add to that the fact that the biggest shareholders are the pension funds, directly or indirectly, and they are again managing the pension funds of the people in Iceland. Then you see that we have become a generally publicly traded and publicly owned company.
So, what kind of an investment option is N1?
Well, I think the market that we are in, our core market being distribution of fuel all around the country, is not a fast-growing market. It's stagnant at best, and so that means that our growth opportunities there are very limited. We have growth opportunities in other products, services and products, but in general, I think our growth opportunities will be limited. However, we have defined our policy for paying out the dividends, and the policy that we have, or the target we've set, is that we will pay at least half or above half of the bottom line profit out as a dividend. So that is kind of the signs we've been setting, the targets that we've been setting, probably limited growth, but paying out the reasonable dividends. So that's one type of stock that people probably want to have in the portfolio.
And finally, what will be the company's main challenges going forward?
Well, we have over the past few months been working on the preparation of this IPO and the registration of the stock in the stock exchange. Parallel to that, we've been working on our strategy and our definition of our strategy, and basically putting in place all the groundwork that we need for future growth. So that will be basically the task for the coming year, is to find out how we use the basis that we have been putting in place, and how we can build on that for future growth. Next to that, we are operating in a very competitive market, and we have to do all we can to make the operation as efficient and economical as possible. So we will have to really focus on how we operate and how we manage our stock and how we manage our all our operations and to make them as efficient and economical as possible. So these will be probably some of the key areas that we will be focusing on in the coming year, at least. Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.